explain a little bit about the course, and because we're doing art and textiles together, hopefully I'll be able to answer the questions. The biggest question is what's the difference, because students will generally pick one or the other if they're into the arts, into the art subjects. Okay, so first thing is, what's in it for you? And I think that one of the most important things that the art course delivers is that it encourages the students their creativity, imagination and independence, because really there isn't a set content for the course in terms of facts. I don't have to make sure that I'm teaching you a load of facts. You go into an exam and you're able to remember those facts, but I'm teaching you skills in which you're able to use to communicate something individual about yourself. Okay, so it's very much about you as an individual and what you, how you use art to communicate something. So it's teaching you a visual language. One of the really good things about the department is it's open 7 days a week, because obviously we've got so many resources that you need to have access to that in order to learn those skills. And so, and that's a really, really important thing. And Ms. Morgan has said as well that we have all this equipment, but you are the most sophisticated piece of equipment we have. It's about discovering something about yourself, not just external facts. Okay, so hopefully if you choose art or textiles, you'll be able to use those skills that you build to say something very personal, and also to build up all those other skills like problem solving and experimenting. Okay, another nice thing about the art department is that as art teachers, we are also all art practitioners. We all practice what we preach. So, and this is a quote from one of our favourite educational theorists. The arts teach children that problems can have more than one solution and that questions can have more than one answer. Okay, so it's very much about building up that confidence to be problem solvers, but also risk takers. You know, you get to experiment, and sometimes those experiments don't work out, but it's okay. So now I'm going to talk about the differences between art, craft, design and the textile design course. So first of all, the art, craft and design covers a big, wide range of processes, 2D, 3D media, including painting, drawing, printmaking, sculpture and ceramics, photography and site-specific art. And I think it kind of speaks for itself as you walk around the art department. You know, every single piece is very diverse and very different range of things. So, for example, even if you choose to do art, the work that's over here is a student who's an art student, but he's produced a final outcome that is a textile-based outcome. It's a shirt, but it's painting on a shirt. So it's gone beyond the traditional canvas and taken a piece of clothing as the canvas. So really, there's an awful lot of crossover. So you can even if you like textiles, you can learn textile process within the art course, and likewise, if you do textiles, you can learn more art-based processes as well. So for the textiles course, pupils are allowed to focus on this area and specialise in surface pattern, digital and screen printing techniques, metal and plastic exploration, machine and hand embroidery, and constructed textiles. And Miss Barton gives me this quote: in other words, textiles explores the surface, which is not necessarily fabric. And she said, I do not have a degree in cushions or dresses. It's more than that. As a teacher, I like to challenge the perception of textiles to make new, innovative artwork. And I think you can really see that in the different types of textile pieces that are out. So, for example, the piece that's back here, I mean, that is the student will have tie-dyed using indigo and shibori, the different fabrics on that. But she's also used PVA glue and glue gun to construct that dress. So it's about taking as many different processes and learning how they can work together to produce the outcome that you've envisaged in design. Okay, now I'm going to talk about the structure of the course. The structure of both art and textile course is the same. You all produce a portfolio, which is what we used to have called coursework, and that's 60% of the overall grade, and then you have an exam in your fifth form, which is 40% of your grade, and they're broken down and assessed in the same way. So I'll talk you through the assessment very quickly. of those. So the first thing you'll do is you develop your ideas. Okay, so this is quite important. You've got to have ideas to know what to do with the skills that you've learned. And so we take the students on a trip at the start of the course to get the ideas going. We give you lots of research, but also you should be investigating and taking independence and finding imagery and artists that inspire you and interest you. And it's not necessarily just artist research, but it's also looking around at different sources to give you those ideas as well. Then, what you do with those ideas, you begin to refine them through exploring and experimenting with different media and materials. And initially, we might start the course with a teacher-led project where we're teaching you as many different processes and techniques as we possibly can, whether that's cardboard construction, darkroom photography, tie-dye, silk painting, ceramics, printmaking, and then you begin to build up this wealth of experience in these different materials and processes, and you can begin to decide how best to explore your ideas and through which processes. The third thing is refining your ideas. So once you've got the experimentation going, you begin to come up with a more succinct direction. And it's very important that you write things down, because of course all the ideas are up in your head, but if they're not written down in your sketchbooks or in your notes, we can't assume that they're there. So recording isn't just about drawing, it's a way of documenting. This can be visual or written. So in this particular slide, the top left are photographic experiments in the darkroom using UV lights and paint, which was inspired by space, project in space. And the top right are drawings and collages combined together. The bottom left is planning and annotation. The physical work, that was work was nothing like the design, and this was justified through the written reflection. It's okay to change your mind. So even when you're at that stage of recording your ideas, you can begin to change your mind as you construct your outcome, because things might change, things might need to change. And then that's what that is, the present, which we sometimes call the final piece. It's what you create at the end of the project. And that can be anything that is developed through all your experimentation. So you can really see when you go outside, because out there on the balcony is mostly their final pieces. They're the present element of the coursework or the exam. And there's a wealth of diversity in the process that are used there. Sometimes a student will do a painting as an outcome, or a photograph, or a light installation. But it's just about supporting the student to find which direction they're most interested in and what's most relevant to their journey. So that's the same, and that's obviously the same for art and textiles. So that's the course assessment objective structure broken down in a drier, more exam board type way. So and those are all assessed with the same mark. So they all get the same mark, and that's the same for art and textiles. It is also the same for the second component of the course, which is the exam. So we mark the coursework and the exam to the same assessment criteria. So the exam, which you will do in fifth form, is a whole new brand new project. And in here you can see there's the boards are out. This is mostly coursework, and there's one example of an exam down here where the student has created a sketchbook project of their ideas, refining and experimenting with those ideas, and then recording their ideas, and then they present the final piece. So the main difference about the exam compared to the portfolio is it's time restricted. So you have 6 to 8 weeks to create the experimentation and refining the ideas, and then you have 10 hours to create your present element of the course, the final piece, and that's done over several days. So they're basically the same, it's just it's time restricted for the exam. Okay, then just finally we got the students to give us a few nice quotes about how they felt on the course, and I'll just read out a few. So, being given a dedicated time and space to express myself, explore and experiment, In 2 years, I made a creepy hand clone, turned my friends into colourful aliens, and made pencils go to war. So it's quite nice because it shows diversity of the experimentation. And then another one is having a very personal topic. There's no right or wrong answer, as the topics can be endless. A week long to do the exam, my favourite thing. And then there was some from Miss Barton's textiles group as well. And I quite like the one, I have an identity through my artwork. It shows how individual we all are. I think that's quite a nice one as well. So hopefully I've been able to answer any questions that you might have had about the difference between art and textiles. I think the best thing to do possibly, if you're still not sure, is have a look at the differences that the textiles project puts out and then the art projects that are out. If you would like to have me email you this PowerPoint, and also we have a PDF file which has got all the sort of dry OCR course from the exam board. I've got a list here if you want to write your name and email address on there. And if you have any questions, then please ask. And hopefully I'll see lots of you next year. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.